They arrive every year about this time, and we have an issue with barn swallows. They nest high up inside the eaves of the buildings, and sometimes they nest over the walkways for students. Parents and teachers walk back and forth to go to class, and unfortunately we have bird feces, mud, twigs, insects, and other things that these birds are carrying with them, which then ends up on the sidewalk. It dries in the sun, which then can turn to powder, and then will be picked up in the wind and blown around the campus, which can be bad for people who have allergies or people who are allergic to things like that. So we have to do our best to try to keep them away from the walkway.
In this case, we let them have the back of our gymnasium because it's just a field back there. There's no one walking back there. All the other areas around campus where there are walkways or paths, we've done our best to try to keep them away by putting up netting underneath the eaves. We've used plastic sheeting, which you can see on one of these buildings right over here in the background, up on the wall, and that is to keep the birds from building their nests on the wall, because all the buildings here are stucco, and the barn swallows like the stucco because they can land, they swallow the mud inside their stomach, then they fly up onto the walls, they hold onto the walls with their claws, and then they regurgitate the mud right onto the stucco, so it sticks real good and they can hold on real good. So they really like the buildings here for that reason. So we put plastic on the walls because when they fly up, their claws don't catch in the plastic, and so they leave that area alone and they move off to another spot. We watch where they go, we follow them. If it's in another area where there's a pedestrian walkway, we put the plastic up or put up the netting and move them on again, and then eventually they get tired of us chasing them around campus and they go up behind the gymnasium again, which is where you'll see them right now. If you guys want to go out there with your camera, you'll actually see them making their nests up on the wall. That area we let them have because there's no one back there and it's the safest place for them to be. And then after they leave at the end of summer, we can go out there on a lift and scrape off all the old nests, wash the windows, and make it look like they were never here, and do it all again the next year. There is no way to prevent them. This is a cyclic thing where they come every year. As the parents build the nests on the wall and the young ones are born there, just because of instinct, they will fly right back to that same nest that they came from. Just like when you leave school today, you're going to go back to your own house. They do exactly the same thing. They will fly right back up onto the wall. Even if the nest is gone the next year, they will fly right to that spot on the wall and build their own nest. So the young ones will always come back the following year. The parents don't, but the young ones do. And unfortunately, there's no way to stop that. That's Mother Nature. Yes, they do cost us money, because besides my time involved and the other night custodian out here cleaning the sidewalks, we have to use power washers. In some cases, we have to use different types of chemical soaps to remove the bird feces. We have to buy rolls of that plastic sheeting that's back here on the building. We have to buy netting and the staples to put the netting up. We, in some cases, have to rent a lift that will take me up high up inside, like the multi-use building over here where you see the wood shop is. We don't have anything that will get us up that high, so we have to rent a lift, which costs hundreds of dollars per day to rent that. So yes, they do cost us quite a bit in the long run while they're here. It'd be nice if they weren't here, but like I say, it's Mother Nature. They're here every year. A smaller area like that right there could take maybe an hour. Well, it's yeah, we have to. If we didn't, this whole wall back here, which is where the cooking class is, that would be just birds' nests all the way down, and then they would fly from there up into the eaves. They would pretty much take over that building, and then everyone walking in and out would have birds swooping down on them, as well as the bird feces would be just everywhere. So it was pretty bad over previous years, but then we figured out the plastic worked great for keeping them away, and since we've been using that, it works even better than the netting. And so the birds have left these buildings alone, and right now they're behind the gym, but who knows, they're not all here yet. They come here by the hundreds, so we've only got maybe an eighth of them that are here right now. I wish they wouldn't come here anymore. I wish they'd find a barn to go to. There are barn swallows. We don't have any barns, but I guess they like our buildings. But other than that, no, I wish they'd just go someplace else.
No. Go up closer, let's go closer.
It's my baseball hat.
Watch when they all dive down. It's cool how they all...
Get them, boys!